Then we have drug-induced movement disorders, which lessen are trying to discipline ourselves not to say EPS, which is a very nonspecific generic term. So drug-induced movement disorders, including Parkinsonism, akathisia. And here you can see the list. Clozapine, lumateperone, iloperidone, and quetiapine tend to be at the best end. And then going down, we have paliperidone, risperidone. Some of this is related to the potency of binding at the D2 receptor. Something to realize, Les, is the D2 partial agonists, the ABC drugs, actually have the highest binding affinity at D2 and are not free of the risk of drug-induced movement disorders, including tardive dyskinesia. Even though people think partial is somehow more gentle.
Yeah, so let me demonstrate what this means with high affinity.
Yeah.
Let's pretend Andy is the receptor and I'm the drug. And in reality, I wouldn't let go. And even if another drug came along and tapped me on the shoulder,
no.
I wouldn't let go.
Yeah. Well, I have that effect on some people.
Yeah. So this list is interesting. Some of it is based on, you know, overall, you know, appraisal of the data. I like to calculate things out and calculate number needed to harm. And then I have a number attached to all this. And I'll share that with you in a few moments.
Yeah.